Well, if you took a step outside last night, you probably saw these painting across the sky, these colors of pink, green, blue, across the scale of the color wheel. And what these are known as, they are called auroras, or what you've also known them as, the northern lights. And so these northern lights will paint across the sky of different colors, pink, green, blues, and it's a beautiful, beautiful sight to see. And you're probably wondering, Ryan, what are these? Like, what exactly is happening that's causing these northern lights or these auroras to occur in the Susquehanna Valley? Well, I'll tell you about that here with this graphic, with this explainer that I have here. So essentially, these auroras are created by these coronal mass ejections, or CMEs, that are dispersed by the sun. And so essentially, this is super hot gas. The sun expels the super hot gas and the particles towards the Earth. Once that hot gas interacts with the Earth or the Earth's atmosphere, it'll travel down the Earth's magnetic field and interact with the Earth's magnetic field and create these colors. And so it'll interact with different particles and atoms like oxygen and nitrogen, just to name a couple of them. And when they're supercharged to that point by these super hot gases, it gives off this light, this beautiful light of purples and greens, pinks and blues, you name it. So it's a very beautiful sight, but it's also a double-edged sword. And this is why I say this. These CMEs, or these geomagnetic storms, can also be disruptive to the radios, GPS, satellites, and even the power grid. So the Space Weather Prediction Center also gives out these warnings to the public, especially the officials who man these power grids, who man the satellite systems, to let them know, hey, this geomagnetic storm is going to be impacting our infrastructure. So that's also, again, it's a double-edged sword, but very nice and very beautiful to see if you take a step outside.